President Trump doesn't always do what people expect him to do or even what his supporters want him to do. Is he being unpredictable? Or could there be another cause, perhaps a magical one? Mandy Yates Garcia is the Oracle of Los Angeles. She says she's a witch, tarot card reader, spellcaster, energy healer, intuitive medium, shamanic practitioner, and magical life coach. Last night, she helped cast a so-called binding spell on our president to prevent him from causing harm to others. We've asked many witches to come on this program, but only Amanda Yates Garcia was brave enough to accept her invitation. She joins us tonight from Los Angeles. Amanda, thank you for coming on tonight. I just had a panic communication in the commercial break with one of my producers, Alex, who said, be nice to her. I don't want a spell on me. So I hope that you'll pull back on your powers and spare our staff. What does this mean exactly, that you cast a binding spell on the president?
Binding spells are like any other spell, so they're a symbolic action used to harness the powers of the imagination and achieve a tangible result eventually. Yeah.
And what was the result that you desired?
Well, I desire that Trump stop harming people that I care about and instituting policies that also harm me or other people that I care about. So my ultimate aim is that we protect the people that we love from having harm done to them. But in the meantime, I think what's really important is that we create a sense of solidarity and empowerment within the people who are participating in the spell, to galvanize them towards action so that they can feel empowered to make the changes that they want to see in the world.
Most people just go ahead and vote or like buy a t-shirt. Is this legal? Can you run around casting spells on? Are you allowed to cast spells on people? Is there any kind of federal regulation of this?
Well, okay, so symbolic action is something that everybody participates in all the time, right? So you might think, oh, that doesn't really have any meaning. But if that were true, then, for instance, why would people care whether or not people saluted the flag or sang the national anthem? That's also symbolic action. And that kind of symbolic action does have power. And that's why people care about it. So while I don't think that any witch is thinking, oh, this is the only action that is necessary to prevent Trump from enacting his mean policies, I think that they're hoping that by doing these symbolic actions that will galvanize people to resist with our hearts, with our full hearts.
So since you're the only witch, I've interviewed a lot of people, but I've never interviewed a witch. Sincere question, is Eye of Newt an actual ingredient?
Well, I think the real problem is not whether or not Eye of Newt is an actual ingredient. The real problem is we're about to have some kind of big nuclear extravaganza with North Korea. The real problem is that we're punishing immigrant children. The real problem is that we're
there are lots of problems, but that's still
to go into deep debt. Okay. I don't think the real problem is whether or not we use Eye of Newt in our
that schools. I'm not suggesting it's a problem, and I'm with you on the student debt, by the way, completely. I don't think Trump did that, but whatever. But it doesn't get to my question, which is Eye of Newt an actual thing or not?
Eye of Newt, isn't that from Shakespeare? So I think he was probably using a little bit of poetic license. Most witches today use whatever we have available to us.
For instance,
candles and paper.
Does it ever worry you? I mean, by the way, I'm not dismissing what you're saying. I don't think that the only things that exist are the things that we can see. There clearly is a supernatural. I don't understand it. But I wonder if you're ever worried about the consequences of bluntly fooling around with things that nobody really understands. I'm sincere. Do you ever worry about that?
You know, a lot of people ask me that, whether or not I worry about the supernatural consequences of what I'm doing. I mean, I trust that what I'm doing is for the greatest good of all concerned, because that's what I hold in my heart. That's what all these witches are doing this for, is because they have the pure intention of creating good in the world, to make a more beautiful, loving, whole, healthy world. And so that's the intention that they're doing this work. So nobody's worried that it's going to backfire on them, because nobody's doing this spell to cause Trump harm.
So you think, I'm not even talking about Trump. I just mean in general.
Harm.
Oh, no, I don't think you are. But you think good intentions will protect you? I don't know. It's kind of spooky, but you seem nice, and I'm glad that you came on.
Yeah, if you need a lesson, Carlson.
No, I don't. Scares me.
Tucker.
I appreciate it, though. Thanks for coming on, Oracle Garcia.
Thank you. My pleasure.